I'm Reverend Patricia Caginello from Sacred Stories Publishing, and we welcome you to our first annual author summit. Today we're speaking with the Reverend Dr. Jane Galloway, the author of The Gateways, The Wisdom of 12-Step Spirituality. So welcome, Jane. Yes, hold up your book cover. Let everyone see your beautiful cover.
Beautiful book cover.
So The Gateways, The Wisdom of 12-Step Spirituality. So Jane, let's talk about your book. What is The Gateways about?
The Gateways was written for really people who have been victims of childhood identity theft. Let me explain what I mean by this. For one reason or another, as young people, frequently we are in family systems for various different reasons. It can be addiction, it can be narcissism, it can be divorce or difficulty, where children are put in the bind of having to figure out who they are based on their elders, on their parents, on the people around them to be safe. And so they develop a compensatory personality. Often addiction helps with that because you can at least, a lot of people become addicted in the process of just trying to get some sort of center for themselves. It's not a long-term solution. Obviously, addiction becomes a real crippling issue all its own. But my work is really for those people, many, many of whom I've worked with over the years, to help them make the journey back down the labyrinth of the compensatory personalities they've created and get back to true center. I use a lot of different tools, the wisdom path of the 12 steps, but not the culture of the 12-step programs. That is the clarification that has taken me a year since my book was published to figure out. So it's
the wisdom path, yeah. not specifically the 12 steps. So just explain your wisdom path, the 12 gateways that you have created.
The gateways combine. I mean, every religion or spiritual system or growth system has layers to it, you know, and so the wisdom path is usually the same in all traditions. So once you go deep enough, Matthew Fox wrote the book, One River, Many Wells. So once you go deep enough, everybody's taught, that's the wisdom path. So I have recognized over the years of working with the 12 steps, being, you know, involved with them at many different levels, that there's a deep wisdom path that is the spiritual part of that program. The more superficial part of how to get sober, stay sober, stop doing some addictive process, et cetera, is critical and wonderful for stage one recovery. What most people I work with are looking at in their lives is, who am I? And this is ultimately the big question we all ask anyway, who am I? So this is about getting to that wisdom path and utilizing, extracting the wisdom from these essences. In other words, the first gateway correlates with step one, but it doesn't just correlate with a step. It also correlates with a chakra, a function, a location, sacred geometric shape, et cetera.
Jane, hold it up more into the thing. So each gateway, it's a beautiful book. It's also, so let's just explain the gateways. It's almost like the first half has your story and an explanation of the wisdom paths. And it's really a beautiful read and explanation. And then the second half, you actually break out each individual gateway, and each one is different, right? So you just mentioned that each one has a chakra. Talk about using one gateway.
So the first gateway correlates with step one, and step one in the 12-step tradition is realize we were powerless over something. So then what I extract from that, almost homeopathically, you know, in homeopathy, you take a little bit of the essence of what you're trying to develop immunity to. All right, so I pull power out of that. So power is the thing. Lack of power, that was our dilemma. That's what this step gets at this wisdom level. So we deal with the chakras. So the base chakra, the root chakra, deals with power, deals with rooting, deals with the color red, with a geometric shape. I believe it's an upside down triangle. I'm trying to think what it is exactly. But so the point is, I teach many different holistic wellness practices for strengthening that level. So if you realize, wait a minute, I'm feeling ungrounded today, and you're working this path, and you're a person who has, now remember, this idea of not really know, looking to others for your identity. The 12 steps are an amazing organizing system. It's almost like a spiritual spine, a psycho-spiritual spine, along which you can always reorganize things. So if you go back and say, okay, I'm at this thing, I'm dealing with power, I feel powerless. Wait a minute, power. So you can get red stones, put them all around you, put a spot of red at different places in your home. Red jasper is one of the stones that goes along with this. I deal with a ritual for each one of the gateways. And by the way, I've used all of these for many years. And so really, I'm writing what I know has worked for me. I use color infusion as one of the, as part of the ritual for this particular layer. So lack of power, that was our dilemma, or we were powerless over some outside substance. So the whole idea is we have to return to ourself, to our center, where we don't need outside substances to define us or to empower us. So one of these color infusion things was taught to me years ago by a holistic healer when I was having a health challenge. And she said, put red stones in water on the windowsill in the sun, let them stay there for about 6 hours, and then drink the water. I did it. And it worked. I mean, I was better. So that's one. So you see, what this does is, you know, I hate the word esoteric for people who might be turned off by that. But there are many different layers of energy in our system. It's not just the more gross layer, which is our body. That's obvious, you know, my arm right here. But then there's the etheric body. There are all these different layers in which healing takes place. And so these gateways each address this layer of healing in a really a developmental way. You know, Maslow was the person who looked at wellness. He said, Abraham Maslow, started this wellness movement or this human potential movement in psychology. He said, why are we only studying abnormal psychology? Let's look at highly successful people, highly functional people. What do they do? And he began, and that really is very much what he, then he began to look at the list. You have to get a base. You have to get a solid base. So this is really for people to strengthen and return to center. And you don't have to be addicted. I sometimes, you know what? I sometimes wonder, because these words are so powerful, 12 steps. And so people immediately think it's a book for people in 12 step programs. Actually, no, I am sharing this for people who are retrieving the power and the centeredness of their identity so that they can then come from that centered place and reinforce it when it's flagging. You can go into a meditation. But I've had a lot of second chakra issues in my life. And so that's orange. So I have a lot of orange stuff around. But also it's you know, hips. I've had 2 hip replacement surgeries. I've also had many, I've had some issues in that second chakra. What Eric Erickson talks about in childhood and society is that that is the generativity stage. So some people, so the reproductive organs are there. So maybe if you're not having a child, maybe you're trying to birth a project. What are the impediments to birthing a project? And so a lot of times I've had so many second chakra things. I'm declaring here today, I'm done. I'm ready. Let's move on. But
So the second chakra in your book relates to the second gateway, though, correct?
The second gateway, and that says, came to believe that a power greater than ourselves could restore us to sanity. So this has to do with really moving back into our right self. We each have an inherently good, solid self. And this place where we begin to, if you look at the chakra system, look at moving out into the world, through generativity, through creating something, whether you create a daughter or create a Broadway show, right? It brings up lots of layers of conflict. So this idea of coming to believe, it's a process step in the 12 steps, but it also correlates with this idea of coming to believe that there is a power with which we can connect, with which we can work at a deep level that restores us to perfect wholeness and sanity, and that original template of our original purpose of incarnating.
Right.
So, yeah.
So the gateways, we can say, are 12 tools, 12 steps, 12 gateways to a wellness-based approach, right? Using the compilation of wisdom paths, of the spiritual traditions and wisdom paths through the ages in each gateway. So in each gateway, and each one is in the book, and it is also laid out beautifully, and there's so much information, and Jane's book is a full color book too, and she has different diagrams and charts explaining. There's so much in the gateways. There's a bento box of tools. I mean, you have to take a look at it. But each one within each gateway, it's really a process within itself based on whether you want to go in order of the steps, right? They do align with what are traditional 12 steps. Or you just, like you said, maybe you're feeling ungrounded one day and you want to dig into gateway one because it has to do with power and the root chakra and so forth. So so each gateway has a chakra, has a stone, has a color, has a process. What else is in each gateway? Just to give everyone a fuller idea of the process or the tools available to them.
A musical note. So if you have a bowl, I have a couple of singing bowls. And sometimes just on a keyboard you can play. So for second, I know a lot about the second chakra. I do a lot of work at that. But the musical notes are D and C sharp. So if you suffuse that that musical note through the room, it makes a difference, a vibratory difference. You know, everything's vibration, and certainly music is vibration, but we're vibration. So this gets us to the place where healing can happen at that level. Also then, so you're dealing, I also correlate each one of these gateways, steps, et cetera, with a Chinese meridian, one of the Chinese meridians. So so this one is bladder, kidney, large intestine. Okay. And then there's the ritual, there's a gland, the reproductive organs, location, where is that? Lower abdomen, second chakra. The functions are emotions, creativity, and sexuality. And the chakra is you know, second chakra. So I wanted to also just mention that in the back, I show many different developmental paths that, you know, can be followed. The Jesus path, the 10 words or commandments from the Torah, the Hindu four ways to God, 10 sacred laws of Native American spirituality, the five pillars of Islam, the eightfold path of Buddha, you know, of the Buddha, of the Bodhisattva vow. So all of these paths you can utilize. You can utilize these along with, I give you a bento box of spiritual tools. So once you begin to practice this as a healing path, suddenly you say, wait a minute, I have all of these tools at my ready. Doctrinaire religious paths, Christianity and all the rest of them, at the most gross level, tell you, you're wrong, I'm right. This goes way deeper and goes, oh, we're all the same. And so right. This is where we access power. And that's okay. What this book is about, how to find the power.
And it's really psycho-spiritual tools, because you also speak about Eric Erickson's eight stages of man, Abraham Maslow's hierarchy you had mentioned, and there's others in there. So what you get with the gateways, if we're just to sum it up, right? I think of it as a wellness-based approach to life, right?
Exactly.
And in addition to this really beautiful explanation of these really truly beautiful wisdom paths throughout the ages, you get 12 different gateways or processes that do align with the 12 steps, even though it doesn't have to be addiction. It can just be a wellness-based approach. But within each gateway are your tools and process, your chakra, your color, your musical note, your ritual, right? Your Chinese meridian, you know, everything. And Jane gives you examples and ideas of how to use all of these elements in order to strengthen yourself, right?
That's really vibration. This really vibration. Is really about raising your vibration. And so mm-hmm. We want to get in sync. God, it makes me almost a little teary. That's what it's about. It's about getting ourselves into the vibration of the Om, the vibration of the sacred Om. We're in a time right now where so much stuff is going on in the air. So much change is happening. Mm-hmm. And my true belief and practice is that if we get ourselves to that vibratory level where healing, where new ideas, where wholeness resides, we create the new model that all this stuff is coming forth to make way for.
Right.
Rather than focusing on, terrible things are happening, say, wow, I see an opening for a new day and a new way and a new vibe.
Great. And you have the tools, the very specific tools to use. I think tools are very important. Jane, hold the book cover up one more time, please, and tell everyone your website so that they can get in touch with you, too.
There it is. The Gateways, the Wisdom of 12-Step Spirituality. My website is janegalloway.com. Very easy. janegalloway.com. You can buy the book on Amazon and many different, all different ways. But that's kind of the easiest, I think, in a way. But I really, this is a book to use, and it's so pretty. I always envisioned this for years. I was drawing diagrams. So I say it's so pretty you could eat this for dessert. Don't. Use it. It's so pretty. And I hope you get this and use it. I worked with someone yesterday with this, and she was kind of intimidated by all of the volume. And then we just worked on the first gateway, and her whole energy changed. She said, this is so wonderful. This is such a wonderful process. So I just encourage you to dig in, use it, enjoy it. It's not something you pick up once and read once. It's really something to use, to go back to and back to and back to, and use it. Use it.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. So Jane Galloway, thank you so much for joining us. And The Gateways, the Wisdom of 12-Step Spirituality is available from sacredstoriespublishing.com too. All right. Books are 20% off through November 30th, so it's a great opportunity to pick up The Gateways. And as Jane said, Amazon, Barnes & Noble is pretty much booksellers worldwide. So Jane Galloway, thank you so much for joining
us.
Thank
you so much. Thank you. Happy holidays to everyone.
And thank you thank you for the audience for joining us. The next show will be up in just a couple of minutes. We'll be with for our beautiful book, Scanning for Signal, Caitlin Abendroth, one of the authors, will be joining us. So until then, thank you very much.
Thanks.